most of what we know about the impacts of poor air quality on health are from countries where we have a lot of data. And these tend to be wealthier countries. Where we have less evidence is in many parts of the developing world. And the reason that's important is because people's lives are sometimes very different in these parts of the world. So in this study, we were particularly interested in the role of dust air pollution. In particular, this tiny corner of northern Chad, this place called the Beaudelet Depression, which is the source of something like half of the world's windblown mineral dust.
Both when women are pregnant and when children are developing in the first year of life, we know they're especially sensitive to these impacts. So we used these health surveys that have been conducted in many countries around the world that asked mothers to record the outcomes for all the births they've had in their lives. So our main finding was that a 10 microgram increase in PM2.5 concentration during the first year of life led to a 24% increase in infant mortality.
Even small increases in dust can lead to large increases in infant mortality.
One of the interesting things about dust is that it's unlike other sources of particulate matter in that it's a lot harder to target the sources.
Is there really anything you can do to keep all this dust from blowing in? And that might sound like the answer is obviously no. But what we can do is we put sprinklers out there. We use groundwater, we pump up the groundwater, and we put sprinklers out and we dampen the ground. Turns out there's actually a lot of groundwater in this part of Sub-Saharan Africa. At least technically speaking, this could be a very cost-effective way to improve infant health across Sub-Saharan Africa.